Hello everyone, my name is Ashfaq Ahmed and I work in the field of structure biology and bioinformatics. Today, I'm going to show you that how will you plot and analyze the results achieved from the AlphaFold3 tree. We have already covered a video like how to use AlphaFold3 where I have taught you like what kinds of matrices are involved there in the form of PLTDT, IPTM, TTM, contact predictions, PAE, like predicted alignment error. So I will drop the result, I will drop the link of that video in the description section of this video. So if you don't know how to use AlphaFold3, you can take that link and run AlphaFold3 for your prediction. But this video is all about, like, once you finish the running or the prediction on AlphaFold3, then if you want to plot those results which are mentioned on the server, so how will you do that? Normally, if you want to use that result for your manuscripts, research papers, then if you are using some, let's say, snipping tool, so that will not generate a high resolution picture, and journal will ask you for a high resolution picture. So therefore, in this video I will show you that how can you analyze your structures and all those things. So let's start. Okay, this is our AlphaFold server, and I will share the description of the video, like how you will use or how to understand different matrices produced by this server if you use it. So you can check the description section. Okay, now when you use it, for example, you have used it, okay, then your jobs will be here. So I will not I'm not going to reuse this server again because I have used it already, and I will share the description section with you. So this is the result, and if we click here, you will see the result some kind in this kind of this window. I have already explained all those things, like what are PLTDT, confidence, blah blah blah, IPTM, PTM. So I'm not going in that detail. Okay, so for example, this is your result, and in this result, let me tell you, I have used wall R. One is the histidine kinase and another one is the response regulator, and it has many domains: DHP domain, catalytic domain, response regulator domain. So I have used a pretty much heavy structure for the prediction. Okay, now from here, when you click download, so you can download these results, and I have already downloaded. So let me show you my download folder. You can see this is the download results. Then I use, because you will download these results in zip form, so I have unzipped these results, and this is the resultant file where I can see some JSON files, some CIF file. Okay, and all these files contain the information about these things. Okay, now let's assume you have used the server, you have downloaded your results. What is next? Next is you have to open your Google Drive like this is my Google Drive, so you must have your own one. Then click here, and when you click here, let's say here, and then let's say I'm creating a new folder and I name it, let's say AF. AF means AlphaFold. Okay, create. So now I will have a new drive, directory here. You can see. Open it. Now, what is next? You have your results here. The unzipped result. Just select them all and drop it here. It will take almost, depending on your internet connection, maybe 30 to 40 seconds. So let's see. Okay, it says 17 uploads complete, and you can refresh this folder. Yes. Now, what is next? You use your Google Drive, make a new directory, paste your results there. Now, what to do next? Just use my repository like you guys always using H100. Okay, and enter it. Oh, okay, I'm sorry, I made a mistake. GitHub. Okay, if you are new to this channel, if you don't know how to use how to open this Colab repository, then I will drop this link also in the description section so you can take it from there. Now you will see this kind of thing. Click here and select BioPython. Here you will see AF3 results visualization. Click here. The first thing you have to do, click connect. It will take some time, maybe 20 seconds or less. Once it is connected, then we will run different cells. We will import our result file. Yes, it is connected. Now, the first step is to mount your Google Drive, just like you are mounting a USB to your computer. So here we are mounting our Google Drive here. So just click here, run anyway. It will ask me for a permission. I will say yes, then I have to click it. If you see this email, please don't email on this Gmail. I'm not using it for email, so this was just a disclaimer. If you want to email me, you can take my Outlook email or Hotmail email from the channel page. You can write to me. Okay, so this is the drive is not mounted. Now click here. You will see the drive option here. Click here. Click here to discover your drive. What was the name of our folder? AF. Click here to see. Yes, it contains all our files, those JSONs, those CIF, blah, blah. Okay, what is next? In front of the directory name, AF, you will see these three vertical dots. Click here and copy path. Okay. What is next? Step two. Just run this cell and you will see something now. It says the folder path and select a model number. So I'm using Control V. This is actually the copy path here, and then Control V to paste it. Okay. Now, this notebook has read our directory, and now you can see 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. these five models are present in my result, so it is up to you which one to open. Let's say I'm opening two. Okay, now it says that we found model 2 MMCIF. Now the first thing is the IPTM matrix. Once again, if you don't know what is IPTM, what is PLDDT, what is PAE, what is contact probability, then I would suggest to watch this video of mine. Let me show you. I will also drop the link in the description section. So this is actually the video. Let me show you the thumbnail. How to use AlphaFold for biological modeling. So I have discussed all these things in a sufficient detail already. So I'm not going to repeat all those things again. So okay, click here. So it will calculate the IPTM matrix for model number 2. So you can see here, it contains, this structure contains A chain, B chain, C, D, E, and F. So already I told you that like this structure contains, this is a multi-domain protein. In your case, it may contain one or two or whatever you say, even a single chain. So okay, now this is the IPTM matrix. It shows you the confidence. Like if you want to see the chain A and chain B, the confidence of A and B now, you can, okay, this is B and this is A. So this one is the AB confidence. This one is the BB confidence. You see B confidence to B. Why I'm seeing the B confidence to B? Because it's a matrix. Okay, now here is the how to say the score boundaries. Again, if you don't know which score is better, I'm not going to tell you here. You have to watch that video, because only knowing the reference point is not sufficient. You need to understand what is IPTM. So therefore, again and again, I'm suggesting you to watch that video, not just for my personal watch time, but for you to understand. Okay, now we are going to calculate the PLDT. Okay, this is the PLDT confidence. Like this is the amino acid or ID, atom ID, whatever you say. Okay, now here you can see this region is with high confidence. This is extremely high, almost 90%. But this is for chain A. If you want to see chain B, click here. Wait for some time, you see it changed. Now see. So this is for this confidence. Now I want to plot the PAE. Predicted alignment error, click here, this cell. Now it will tell you which regions contains a high predicted alignment error. For example, if we talk about 646 residue from 775 residue, so this alignment error is on the higher side. The yellow, you can see it's almost a 30. So now alternately you can check your model in any visualizer, discovery visualizer, Chimera, Pymol, whatever you are using. So you will see that which region is this, and in comparison, because this is a matrix, so if you want to compare, then you can compare it with this. Or if you don't want that, that's also okay. Okay, now here is a contact probability map. If you are interested to retrieve the contact probability map, so it will be like this. And if there is some contact point, let's say here, I would say a yellow. The yellow means high confidence, or 1 means 100%, 0.8 means 80%, 60%, 40. So if you see here, this is the yellow. Okay, here is the contact probability. So if you keep a ruler here, so it's just like this point is between, I would say, after 130, could be 160 or 170 amino acid in this region, and this one is almost 640, 46 or 4, okay, we will say 646. So 646 and 132. These two amino acids are interacting with each other from different chains. Okay, but once again, for model 2, we are talking for model 2, and here you can save the analysis things, and now you have already those new files are generated in the form of PNG. You can download it and bang from here. Okay, I hope this video will help you in your research and in the interpretation of AlphaFold3 results, and in the understanding, and for understand completely, if you haven't watched that video, so I'm afraid you may not understand this video completely. So I would suggest, I would strongly recommend to watch that to understand the modeling processes and those errors and all those things. And in this video, this is kind of technical video how you can generate publication quality images for the AlphaFold results. Thank you so much. If you're liking my video, please subscribe and share this channel. Bye bye.